Who misses Asia? Misses the future. While Europe and North America talk about low growth rates, aging populations and weaknesses in their financial systems, Asia's economic growth rushes from one success to the next. Asia is creating jobs and prosperity. It is developing large domestic markets and rapidly gaining global political influence. At breakneck speed, the continent is transforming economically and politically into a global powerhouse. With 4.3 billion people, Asia represents 60% of the world population. In 2050, the number is expected to be over 5 billion. Today, Asia generates 35% of the world's gross national product, and this figure is expected to exceed 44% in 2035. The 21st century is the Asian century. However, high population growth, as well as growth in economic output and consumption, confronts large parts of Asia with enormous challenges in energy supply. Energy demand rose 72.5% between 2000 and 2010, and there is no foreseeable end to this trend. Asia's share of worldwide energy consumption is expected to rise from 34% today to 50% in 2035. The key problem: because it lacks its own fossil fuel resources, Asia is required to generate 88% of its energy with imported and expensive coal, oil and gas. Large parts of the region have obsolete and inefficient infrastructure. There are hardly any high-capacity national and cross-border electricity grids. The result: an unstable and inadequate energy supply characterized by high electricity rates and rapidly progressing pollution of the environment. Economic development is at risk, also endangering people's quality of life and the region's growing prosperity. Therefore, systematically developing renewable energy and using intelligent clean technologies is seen as the best alternative. An abundant supply of solar, wind, hydro, biomass and geothermal resources are available in many regions of Asia. Power plants are relatively affordable to build and operate. Unlike in Europe, electricity generation from renewable energy outside metropolitan regions is also competitive without government subsidies. Renewable energy is also available quickly. For example, solar parks can be built in a few months, completely unlike conventional power plants, which often require more than 10 years from the beginning of planning to the start of commercial operation. As an additional plus, renewable energy can be built on a smaller scale than traditional power plants. This makes them ideal for decentralized power generation in rural areas. They therefore produce local electricity for local consumption. And finally, renewable energy protects the environment, the local inhabitants, and their living conditions. Sustainable infrastructure offers communities and the economy a secure and affordable energy supply, reducing dependence on imports of fossil energy resources. This therefore stabilizes Asian growth, creating further prosperity as a basis for a peaceful century. This means that it makes sense not only ecologically, but also economically. The new green energy world on the most populated continent has therefore become an economic reality. Investors recognized this growth market long ago and have generated high earnings here. Between 2004 and 2012 alone, the investment volume in renewable energy in the Asia-Pacific region has increased ninefold. In 2012, $100 billion, half the worldwide investment in renewable energy, flowed to Asia. This makes Asia the worldwide leader in this sector. The ThomasLloyd Cleantech Infrastructure Fund capitalizes on its direct access to potential earnings in this future market and consolidates some of Asia's most attractive sustainable infrastructure projects in its portfolio. And to date, it has done this with great success. Since being launched, the fund has generated above average performance for its investors. Many of the projects realized, on which ThomasLloyd acted either as advisor or investor, are today considered benchmark transactions in their respective countries and regions. Consequently, the fund, project, and fund management regularly receive top ratings from leading rating agencies and analysts. The basis for selecting each project is an investment process developed by ThomasLloyd that has received multiple awards and was developed for the requirements of investors in emerging markets. The goal is to identify and implement the right project in the right place at the right time. To do this, ThomasLloyd's interdisciplinary team of experienced investment specialists continually reviews the individual countries and specific regions of Asia, using an extensive catalogue of criteria. These include current and forecast key financial and economic figures, existing capital and energy market structures, political stability, the general security situation, and the legal system. Additional criteria are climatic, geographical and topographical conditions, as well as the availability and usability of a country's renewable energy resources. All of this determines attractiveness and suitability for investment, both for a country and for certain technologies. In this way, the fund team identifies today's most attractive investment locations, as well as the most promising regions for tomorrow and beyond. The fund team categorically excludes locations that do not offer reliable planning and attractive risk-adjusted returns. The specific project is selected after a potential location has been chosen. A key criterion for project selection is a convincing return on investment, accompanied by the project developer's extensive experience and proven track record in the target region and in the target technology. However, for overall success, the timing of the purchase and sale of a project is crucial. By entering late, the fund avoids many of the risks of the development phase, and by selling early, it bypasses the comparatively less profitable power plant operating phase. The fund chooses to focus on the construction phase because, of all three phases, this is the one that offers highest potential for capital appreciation combined with quantifiable risk. It is therefore the most attractive opportunity and risk profile. In the first step, the fund acquires the rights directly from local project developers to fully developed renewable energy power plant projects that are ready for construction. In the second step, the fund optimizes the project from the perspective of earnings, taxes, and risk management to maximize its resale value. In the third step, via an international tender process, the fund awards the contract for the construction of the power plant and its subsequent operation. The fund finances the construction of the power plant and coordinates and supervises on-site work with both its own and externally mandated specialists. In the last step, after the power plant has commenced commercial operations, the fund seeks to sell to the highest bidding investor before starting the investment cycle again. Over the years, an actively managed, broadly diversified portfolio is created, offering the investor the greatest possible potential earnings with quantifiable risks. The ThomasLloyd investment specialists have currently identified the Philippines as the most attractive location in Asia, and therefore the focus of the fund's investments. With over 90 million inhabitants, the Republic of the Philippines is the second largest country in Southeast Asia. Historically, it is particularly strongly oriented towards Europe and North America. English is the national language, and the majority of the population is Roman Catholic. It is a constitutional democracy with a multi-party system. Its legal system most closely approximates that of Western countries. The Philippines has one of the highest growth rates in Asia, accompanied by low inflation. According to the International Monetary Fund, the country's gross domestic product will rise 47% between 2011 and 2018. For comparison, within the same period, Germany is only expected to grow by 8%. All internationally significant ratings agencies rate the creditworthiness of the Philippines positively. In fact, the country has a better credit rating than many countries in Southern Europe. The Philippines is considered attractive throughout the world. Most of the 500 largest international corporations have a presence there. Some have even chosen the country as the center for all their Asian activities. However, rapid economic growth and increasing prosperity, accompanied by the lack of a national electricity grid connecting the country's more than 7,000 islands, regularly leads to power shortages and not infrequently to power failures. The result? The Philippines have one of the highest electricity prices in the world. At the same time, the country's location to the west of the Pacific Ocean and its proximity to the equator offer many advantages, such as a strong agricultural sector and practically inexhaustible resources of solar, wind, biomass, and geothermal energy. The Philippines is already the world's second largest producer of geothermal energy after the United States. The country possesses the ideal conditions for the fast, cost-effective, and decentralized development of its renewable energy infrastructure. The government shares this view, and in 2008 introduced the legal framework for further development with the Renewable Energy Act. The ThomasLloyd Cleantech Infrastructure Fund's portfolio in the Philippines currently includes 9 power plant projects with an overall implementation volume of over $700 million. Currently, 4 utility-scale solar parks, 1 wind park, and 4 biomass power plants are underway, which will provide over 1.4 million people with sustainably generated electricity. Another location with great market potential is Cambodia, which also offers excellent conditions for renewable energy. The country is located on the Gulf of Thailand, between Thailand, Laos, and Vietnam, and has 15 million inhabitants. According to the International Monetary Fund, its gross domestic product will rise 62% between 2011 and 2018. Between 2000 and 2010, economic growth caused power consumption in the country to increase by 426%. Even today, the energy supply from state electricity companies can hardly keep pace with the growing demand for energy. For this reason, the government is promoting private investment in the country's infrastructure for electricity generation. The ThomasLloyd Cleantech Infrastructure Fund's portfolio in Cambodia currently includes 3 utility-scale solar power projects with an overall implementation volume of over $75 million. After their planned completion, the power plants will provide clean energy to 348,000 people. The fund's investment specialists are also considering additional target markets. These include Indonesia, Vietnam, India, and Sri Lanka. Anyone who wants to invest successfully in dynamic markets such as renewable energy needs extensive investment expertise and highly developed skills specific to this sector and to individual countries. As the responsible fund manager, ThomasLloyd brings these key skills to the ThomasLloyd Cleantech Infrastructure Fund. The company is a leading global investment banking and investment management group solely dedicated to the renewable energy sector in Asia. The management has many years of international experience in leading positions in well-respected commercial and investment banks, leading companies in the field of engineering, construction, and project management, as well as some of the world's largest energy companies. They have successful experience in 100 utility-scale projects across 22 countries in the renewable energy infrastructure sector, with a transaction volume of over $3 billion. Some of ThomasLloyd's specialists and managers have been advising companies, project developers, governments, wealthy private individuals, and institutional investors each for more than 35 years. This makes ThomasLloyd one of the world's most capable contacts for infrastructure investments in the renewable energy sector in Asia, and the ThomasLloyd Cleantech Infrastructure Fund the first choice for intelligent investment solutions in this market.